number of reasons, but I think mainly because of the fact that growing up, I always looked around and I didn't see people of my kind, you know, in those particular roles. And I always wonder why. And I think that that why always stuck with me. I think that my students in particular is the fact that I'm a very open book. I like to talk about my candid experiences growing up, my feelings as a teenager, the different issues, the different troubles, the different kinds of things that I think we seem to all go through. But the fact that they're able to identify with that, I think it puts them in a situation where they feel very connected, very real. As far as the community, I think that any time that we advocate or we ask for things, and everything is in the name of making sure that we give these kiddos the opportunities, irrelevant to who you go to. I mean, I have yet to run into somebody that, you know, will give us a straight answer, no, for something that is for the kids. I have got so many, but I think that if one would stick to me, it would be the 2010 when I was appointed to Simmons Career Center. And take it back, 2006, cut myself short. When I first came, the students were only able to earn the performance-based diploma, which was a little bit better than the GED. And I think that with my think tank, we advocated for us to be able to award the standard diploma. In 2012, we ended up with 5 standard diplomas, all teen mamas. And ever since then, the fact that we get to graduate, you know, kids with standard diplomas have an impact not only in the Plant City area, but in the community. And to know that this particular graduate is going to go get married someday, now we've impacted double the amount. And so I think that impact, and all that you had a change in that philosophy, I think would always be one of my favorites. I think that, you know, make sure that when you're trying to lead, that you also take care of yourself. Make sure that you do me time. For me, me time is running at 5:15 in the morning, every morning, making sure that you have got time for your family, and making sure that you have got time to work, and make sure you have got time for celebrations, but you have got to have a balance. Life is so short, and it's not everything just about work, because that's gonna get you run down and you're gonna run into some health issues. So make sure that you have got a creative balance, but more importantly, make sure you take care of yourself. I think that what I enjoy most is the fact that I know that each and every day it's a responsibility. But I think that if we don't laugh, and we don't connect to kids, and we don't connect to custodians, bus drivers, and everything else, the job becomes a lot heavier than what it needs to be. And I think that when you're able to laugh and you're approachable and kids know that they can get around with you, and custodians know that they can get around with you and everything else, your workload at the end of the day is still a lot of responsibility, but it doesn't have to be. It can be lighter.